Hi, my name is Tatiana Sanchez. I'm the commercial horticulture agent for Alachua County for the University of Florida. And in this video, we're going to talk about petiole sap testing for vegetables. For that, we need some equipment. You will need probes for nitrogen, and we also have one for potassium that you can use any brand that you want, that you feel comfortable with. And one of the most important aspects of the probes that you use is that you learn how to calibrate it, because your measurement is only going to be as good as your calibration. So we will need nitrogen and potassium probe. You're going to need a cutting board, a garlic press, some distilled water, and some paper towels. In this exercise, what we're going to do is we're going to select the most recently matured leaf out of your crop. From there, we're going to analyze the amount of nitrogen inside the sap, as well as the amount of potassium. In today's exercise, we're going to do it with tomato. And we also have a calibrated table that tells us, depending on what stage of the crop, where your nutrients should be, what would be the range, the correct range of nitrogen and potassium at a specific time in your crop. When you're looking at the plant you're going to sample from, you want to take a look at the young leaves and take a notice of the color and the expansion of those leaves. As you move your way down, you're going to find that the older leaves are darker in color and they're fully expanded. When you run into two leaves that look very similar, then you're going to compare what the color and the expansion is. For example, within these two leaves, the size is pretty much identical. So I can say with confidence that this is the leaf that I need to sample. This is the most recently mature leaf. Something you have to keep in mind when you're reading your plants to take your sample is, for excess of nitrogen, plants are going to do things like sucking. This is normal for tomatoes, but when we increase too much the solution, we get suckers, which is basically an additional branch coming out of a node. In this case, this sucker is stealing energy from the main stem and the main leaves. We have a smaller example down here. If I were to try to remove these suckers at this stage, I will leave a big scar in the plant, which is not ideal. You want to remove the suckers right around this stage when they're small enough that if you pinch them out, you won't be creating a big injury on your plant. An additional aspect to keep in mind when we are increasing excessively our nitrogen inside the sap is we're going to notice symptoms such as this one. If you see, this part of the plant should be entirely full of flowers, but instead we have leaves. This is how it should be. So we have a good production. But now our excess nitrogen has pushed the plant to go from reproductive growth to vegetative growth, which will ultimately affect our yield. Depending on your crop, you're going to have simple leaves or compound leaves. For example, this cucumber leaf has an extended blade and a single petiole. Same with basil, same with pepper. So if this is one of your crops, all that you would be sampling would be the petiole part, which would be this one. For tomatoes though, since we have a compound leaf, we have to remove the leaflets. You want to sample multiple leaves per greenhouse. Just make sure you have a represented sample for your area. You won't need to collect any sap from the leaves. The reason to that is, as the plant continues to transpire, it will be sucking the sap from the main petiole. So you want to remove the leaf blade really quickly after you have cut your petiole. Once you have your sample, you want to make sure that you remove the blade as soon as possible. When you get your petioles, you're going to chop them into smaller pieces so you can easily press them with the garlic press. just for example, right now, I collected two leaves of tomato. If you have a larger area, you need to collect a representative amount. The next step, once you have your petiole, is to press it, and you will need about a few drops of sap to be able to read your nitrogen and your potassium. Now it's time to use your calibrated probes for both nutrients. Just a few drops are enough to take the measurement. In just about a couple minutes, you can easily see if you have enough nitrogen or potassium. The time in the day that you want to collect your samples can be anywhere from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m., but it's highly recommended that you keep that time pretty consistent so your results are more accurate. After you get your reading, you can go ahead and check on the multiple tables that have been calibrated for your area for the amount of nitrogen and the amount of potassium that should be in the sap for the specific period of your crop. For the purpose of this explanation, we have increased the amount of nutrients in our nutrient solution by adding calcium nitrate to our plants. That allows us to show you what excess nitrogen symptoms will look like, as well as what would be the numbers that you would get if you have an elevated amount of nitrogen in your solution. So in this example, after we have squeezed the sap out of our petiole, we find that our nitrogen is at 1500 nitrogen. For this time in the season, which is actually tomato greenhouse harvest season, our nitrogen level should be between 700 and 900. This confirms that our nitrogen is too high. At this stage of the crop, the fruits should be soaking all that nitrogen, and that's why our nitrogen drops down. But since we have been adding additional nitrogen, our numbers are extremely high. Same is the case for the potassium. For this time in the year, they should be between 3,500 to 4,000, and they are at 6,700. For large operations, you might have to conduct this in multiple greenhouses, which could be time consuming. A way that you can make this process more efficient is by collecting the samples, removing the blades of the leaves, and store the petioles in a plastic bag in a cooler. You can then go to a cold place in a lab, for example, and read the amount of nitrogen and potassium that you have in all the different petioles from the different greenhouses that you manage. You can freeze the petioles, or you can store the petioles in a cooler for up to 8 hours. But remember that when you're going to read your sap, you want to bring those petioles back to room temperature. There is no need to keep those petioles cold if you're going to read the sap quickly after you collect the sample. No more than 2 hours at room temperature. Now that we have gone through the process of selecting the sample and measuring the sap, we're gonna go back and make a summary of everything we've done so far. So first of all, make sure that you have all the equipment that you need to be able to take this sample. Then read your plants, look at your crop, and select the most recently mature leaf to make sure you have the most balanced nutrients for your sample. Make sure you collect a representative sample of the area that you're cropping. Remember to always try to keep your sampling hour the same to achieve accuracy and consistency in your results. It's important that you are familiar with your equipment and that you feel comfortable using it, but more importantly is that you know how to calibrate it and have it done appropriately. Remember, you can use this equipment not only to check the nutrients in your sap, but you can also check that the level of your nutrient solution is exactly at the level that you need it. Thank you for watching this video. We hope you include it in your nutrient management program.